soldier, dreadlock rasta. There was a buffalo soldier in the heart of America, stolen from Africa.
Greetings, War Thunderers, and welcome to my guide for flying the F2A-3 Buffalo in arcade. This is a Tier 1 plane, currently at a battle rating of 2.7. Used to be much lower, but has been systematically raised over the past year, to the point where many people now feel that it might be over-tiered. Looking at the plane, it's your typical short and stubby US Navy fighter. It has four 50 cal machine guns, two in the wings, two in the nose. And because there's two in the wings, convergence does matter. So let's have a quick look at the internals of this Buffalo, starting with the armour. And as you can see, it has no armour. Yes, the pilot is completely exposed. I'll switch to the other internals. What I'm looking at here are the fuel tanks, only small, located in the wings as usual. Although they're in between the struts, but the struts are thin with big gaps between them, so they're really not very well protected at all. And that also implies that the wings themselves won't be very strong. There's the oil and cooling systems and so on in the normal places, but basically because this plane is not strongly built and with no armor for the pilot, just don't expect to survive if you get hit. So with that done, let's go to a test flight. As usual, I'm flying smoke, putting the plane into a 90 degree bank and just hauling back on the elevator key, and I'm getting a feel for its ability to turn. And what I'm looking at here is it's a very small looking turn circle, and it's almost about to catch up with its smoke trail. So this is very close to being a turn fighter. Against most energy fighters, this plane will be able to outturn them, although against a proper turn fighter it will probably struggle. Now I'm going to employ both elevator and rudder at the same time, and the rudder is very strong. It's pulling the plane over more than the elevator wants to pull it up, and with the both of them combined I am catching the smoke trail in this climbing spiral. Plane doesn't want to climb quite as well as some others, but it's probably down to its lack of engine power, which is something I'll touch on later. On the other hand, it can keep on in this maneuver until quite a low airspeed. That tells me if you need to turn, use the rudder, not just elevators, because it makes a significant difference. Okay, over into a dive, and we'll get a feel for its high speed handling and its roll speed. Its roll speed is fairly good. And in fact, it stays fairly good, well past 400 kilometers an hour. Well past 500 kilometers an hour, it's still rolling really well. It only starts to stiffen up, getting close to 600. And even then, it's quite usable. Now, though I didn't test it there, the rudder also remained very responsive. So the high-speed handling of this plane is exceptionally good. And now, in a purely vertical zoom climb, I'm testing how much altitude it can recover if pushed to the absolute limit like this coming out of a dive. Now, it started that zoom climb at around 1,000 meters of altitude, and I'm getting up to 3,000 before I absolutely have to turn it over, and I'm using a hammerhead turn to do so, and it retained its control quite well in the hammerhead as well. But I level out around 2,800 meters, that's about an 1,800 meter gain, which for a Tier 1 fighter is quite exceptional. So I'll be using this first and foremost as an energy fighter, using its turn fighting abilities when appropriate. And with that, let's go to battle, where I'll be commentating live. Hey, welcome to Team Buffalo. I'm flying with two good friends, Fiddlesticks and Yubided, both fine pilots and excellent squadmates. Flying in this game in the dead of night in my time, so I'm just quietly talking away to myself. We're not on TeamSpeak. I'm trying to be quiet because my family are all asleep. I do not want to wake them. I should probably be asleep myself, but I am a bit of an insomniac, which is totally beside the point. Right, we're trying to climb up to altitude in our Buffalo squad. And as you can see, we're holding quite low degrees of climb, because the plane's capable of climbing right down to 170, 160 kilometers an hour. Even so, it's not what you'd call a good climber. It's rather mediocre. And that comes down to its poor engine power. Its acceleration is fairly slow. It feels like an early war plane that belongs in Tier 1. But nonetheless, even though we only have Tier 1 planes in our lineup, and the Buffalo is the highest ranked, and we've averaged down to 2.3, There are 3.7 tier 2 planes in this game. At least there's no tier 3 planes as well that I've seen yet. Though it wouldn't surprise me if there were. Yes, I do like Killing and Chilling as a name for a video series. Maybe I should apply it to these late night games. But I'll probably use this footage for a video on the buffaloes in particular at some point. Right, so we have bombers up high. The altitude is totally uncontested. So what to do? Should we go for bombers? Are there people to boom and zoom? KO-49. It's too close, I can't ignore him. Got a nice shot at him from underneath, which means I should be clear of any gunners. And to set him alight with the Freedom Cals is a good start. Yep, I'm closing in, so I should be able to finish him off. Nice. There's an 88. Anyone climbing? Doesn't look so. Yep, one of those games where the entire enemy team just didn't care about high altitude except for the bombers, who are therefore completely exposed. And have no answers against the depredations of an evil buffalo squad. And notice my plane is keeping around into the mid-300s quite easily. IAS up here at altitude. It is performing... Nice, got him. It is performing far better than it does lower down, though it's still not what you'd call a great plane up here. But look at that acceleration. That is much faster than I would get if I was down at 1,000 meters instead of up above 4. So it takes a while to get up here. And this B5N2 is flying way too straight in the presence of enemy fighters. You just do not do that in a B5N2. Takes a while to get the plane up here, but it's not bad when it is up here. And it fiddles into a boom and zoom, so I'll just trail him to see if he picks up any followers as he zoom climbs. Doesn't appear that he has. So I will zoom climb as well. Another look at the situation. Still no one climbing to follow us. And there's a Stuka, but let's see what he is. He is a B2. Always have to check. Don't want to go anywhere near a D5 and then get a rude surprise. Okay, so into a low yo-yo attack. Stop him from diving. He's not even trying for a head-on. Okay. Not sure what he thought would happen then, but I bet that wasn't it. Right. What to do? There's no bombers just now. Are there any climbing fighters? P-38 maybe. But let's give him a go. He is definitely climbing, though not at a steep angle, because I'm not closing in that fast. Looks like Phil Sticks is making a run at him as well. In fact, he's closer. I better not run into him. Okay. Well done, Fiddle. Back into a zoom climb, gain of altitude back. I do not want to get embroiled in a ground level furball just yet. Not if I don't need to be. Okay, another KO-49 has spawned. There's a beanbag down to my left, Hunker 111. A 110 looks like he is climbing. So I'm just going to maintain this climb angle. Got to be careful not to get too slow here in case someone helicopters and catches me. I'm not at 4,000 meters yet. Looks like Fiddle has picked up the 110. There is a 400 following him pretty close, and I think that... I could probably catch that KF-49, but it might take me a little while. And my friends are both engaged down there, so I really don't want to be separated. So I'll give up on the KF-49 and come to join them. Actually, looks like Fiddle has that 400. Trying to follow him. There's a Tiffy coming in, I can't engage just yet, and an LA-5. So I'm just going to pull up, make sure I'm not their target. Right. No other new planes coming in. See who I can pick up. LA's turning too sharply. 400 looks good. Here we go. Great, send him a light. And I'll just zoom climb out. Good, he's down. The LA is still down there. Can't see anyone else. And my friends are braver than me. They're both happily engaging down there in dogfights at low altitude. In my experience when I do this, despite this plane's turning abilities, I inevitably get blindsided. And yes, I think they should break off. Because there's a zero coming in, but at the moment not much else. But they may not want to break off. Looks like they're enjoying themselves. Camped out beneath the enemy spawn like that. Is that spawn camping? Right, see if I can pick someone else up in this mess of planes that's gathered down there. No one's attacking my squad mates. They're all chasing a PBY. Which is admirably performing as a target drone. I do like how the Buffalo behaves in a dive. Its roll speed is excellent, its rudder is great. It just maintains perfect maneuverability at high speed. Just extending away from these guys. It looks like one of my squad mates is picking up that BF-109. So I'll concentrate on those other two. UB has him by the looks of things. They're still going on the PBY. Yep, UB has dropped the 109, so it's just these two left. And we're well away from their spawn now, so I can be quite aggressive knowing no one's going to appear right behind me and above me. Oh, the PBY got the F2A. Good for him. Right, see if I can get this guy off his tail. Speaking of his tail, he's just lost it. Never mind. PBY, I shall avenge you. And the 400 wants to dogfight me, which is a bad life decision on his part. I can easily follow his spiral dive here. And there goes his tail control. Kill number 6. How did I get to 6? Right, I have a 190. He was in the 109 earlier on. He's diving in for some kind of revenge. I'm just going to hide behind this hill over here. There's no way in the world I can outrun a 190, but if I can get him to turn fight, that'd be great. And he certainly can't intercept me if I'm zigzagging around behind a hill. Yep, he's overshot me now. Just to see where he is. There he is. And he wants to turn fight. Wonderful. Please keep turning. Don't run away. Fiddle's here with me as well. That's how not to fly a 190 against a pair of buffaloes. Shortly thereafter, this battle wound down to an end, so as I help Fiddlesticks shoot down this last 109, what has this revealed to us? Well, firstly, you can actually hunt bombers with this plane. It performs quite well up at high altitude, and it seems to be an exceptional energy fighter. It's certainly not as good as some other low-tier energy fighters, such as the Hayabusa or MC-202, but it is certainly up there and it can certainly compete. By the way, I'm flying with the ammo belt set to stealth, and the convergence set to 300 meters, although 400 meters often works just as well. So with that, let's go to another battle. This time it's a domination, and I'm flying solo. This one's on the Kalkan Gold domination map, which I feel is the best domination map in the game. Strangely, only available to low tiers, even though the map is so big and will work so well for higher tier planes. Anyway, I'm picking up the action, approaching the sea airfield near the start of the game. Right, looks like I'm going to be a bit too late. A5M4's overshot, so it's just this I-16. Just light him up. Okay, that's one pest gotten rid of. A5M4 is far less of a problem, simply because it's terribly undergunned. Now I'm just going to rope-a-dope him. Just running straight away, he'll have hardly any energy because he pulled a sharp horizontal turn, so I'm just coming straight back, because I don't think he can hold his nose. No, he can't. His nose has dropped. And that's an easy kill. Notice how smooth and quickly the plane responded in that hammerhead. It was just over in the blink of an eye. I do love how this plane handles. Give it an engine with 1,000 more horsepower, it would just be beautiful. Right. Looks like he's coming straight for me, so I'm going to go in a snap roll. Avoid the head-on. Then pull up. Might catch him if he tries to pop and follow. No, he's diving away from this guy. I have to stay engaged, though, in case he still has me as his target. And a pilot kill is always welcome. Right, three very quick kills to start off. Okay, I see no need to tangle with that Chiker. I'm just going to gain some energy, some altitude, and wait for the next load of planes to come in. Suddenly there's a whole stack of company here, which is good. And they're capping the base. Fair number of incomings on the way. Yak 1 I'm going to have to watch very carefully. Now I expect that D3A1 to run past and... he wants to dogfight. Okay. It's maneuverable, but it's not that good. Better not run into him. And the reason it's not that good is that it runs out of speed very quickly. I'm just going to keep my energy fighting approach, just making passes in from above, then extending away. I'm not slowing down to turn with them, even though this plane can turn quite well. It certainly can't turn as well as a Chiker or anything like that, and I just don't want to get caught down in that furball. Rather, doing this lets me look around, reassess the situation, choose when and where to make an attacking pass. I'm thinking the Yak 1 at the moment seems to be fairly slow. Okay, didn't get much of a hit, now I'll try the D3 again. Nice burst at that one. Okay. Once again pull up, now they're both on fire. And there's another incoming on the way, so I'll just run away from him. Might as well get some more. No. Okay. 4 points down, and we've cleared the enemy away again from this area. And that is another Chiker on the way in. Right, this is just a bit of a lull, and I'm going to use it to gain as much altitude as I possibly can. I don't expect that lightning to be able to do a great deal. Looks like he's crashed or something. Okay, next wave. We've got some powerful planes. The X-7 and a Hellcat. There's another F2A lurking off to the left there I've got to be careful of. It's interesting, they haven't come over to sea. They've gone to no man's land in between. And in a situation where either A or C needs to be capped by the other team, everyone wandering to the middle for a totally irrelevant furball seems a bit of a strange decision. But there is another wave of them coming, so I'm loath just to dive into that in case someone does head for the base. I'd rather be in a position to be able to intercept them, like I think that F2A down there is doing. So I'm just going to go straight into a boom and zoom attack on him. Keep looking around at the others. Okay, he's definitely isolated. It should be simple, I hope. Just aiming ahead of that lead indicator. There we go. Yeah, the buffaloes can't take much damage. That's for sure. And as TX141, my friend, would say, there's my ace in the day. Alright, they're still going with this mid-map furball. Tickets are still bleeding down. Surely this can't get going for the rest of the battle. Doesn't look like there's any more friendly planes there, actually, so I expect them to disperse quite soon. In fact, yes, they're all gone. So now I've got to watch them. That P-40 is coming at me, is the guy I just took out in the F2A, so I'm going to lift up into a climb. And I think the X-7 down there is also trying to climb at me as well, so it's a good thing I'm doing this. And you can see it's still climbing quite well, even right down to 150Ks. I could have kept going, but I don't want to be too stalled out there in case one of those guys got more energy than I thought. Looks like the P-40 might have stalled. But he's also running away from me, whereas this Heinkel is still climbing. I should probably have zoomed there. They're tough little things, those Heinkels. I always find them hard to drop. Okay, just taking every opportunity to just keep looking around. Zoom climbing back up again. In short, you fly this thing like an energy fighter. And you use its turning abilities when you need to. Oh, that Heinkel's still there. And he's trying to get a bead on me. Okay, just going a little bit evasive in my dive. The reason I'm not going to dogfight him is stuff's happening over here at sea, and I think I'm needed to overhear more to add to the numbers. Okay, is there anyone I can pick up? I-15's nice and slow. And he might be trying to cap as well. Right. Can't let him cap either. And there's... Okay, I think I stole that kill, but the plane had to die. Can't afford to let up to cap. Alright, the Heinkel is still on me. And now he is gaining. He has superior speed. Energy retention, which does not surprise me in the least. Those things can retain a lot of energy, so I'm going evasive. First the hard break, and then a second hard break the other direction. Makes it very hard for him to get guns on me. But I should be able to outturn him. Except he's running away, so... Right, got another one of them. Don't have a good shot on him, though. Oh, okay. Don't know how I killed that guy, but I'll take the kill. And I have to keep an eye on this fellow. If I can get a shot at him, I will, because the game's just about over. And I can't see them capping C now. Oh, that's all done. And that was quite a fun game.
So, with that, this battle drew to a close. And just to, again, reaffirm how good this plane can be if flown correctly, I actually got 8 kills in that battle and came well on top of the leaderboard, despite being in a battle with at least 3.3 battle-rated planes from Tier 2. So the plane certainly can compete. In my last example, I'll rejoin another battle with Fiddlesticks and Yubided. This time, we have to fight for control of high altitude against higher-tiered planes. And as in the other examples, I commentated live as I was flying.
So this is one of those domination games where there is going to be an initial fight for higher altitude, and the 109 is quite a threat to start off with. I'm thinking he's coming straight at me. Looks like I'm not the only one who's thinking that, but he isn't. Which one of us has he picked up? He's picked up the H6K. Okay, no worries. I don't have the energy to go after him though, but I do have the energy to go at this. I do have to go at this P-47 because it looks like he was picking me out. No more P-47. Great. Right, back onto this 109. Not quite as easy to kill as a P-47. And he has a lot more energy than me and a lot more engine power. He's just running away from me now. So I'm just blinking away, hoping for a hit. Oh, a P-400 has also joined us. Maybe a Corsair's on the way. And the P-400's coming at me. Time to go evasive and a snap roll. Right.
on Yubi. That H6K is certainly drawing a fair bit of attention. I'm still trying to chase him. I can't keep pace with an H6K though. It's outrunning me, which is why the fighters chasing it are also outrunning me. But I have to keep after these two because they're so high. Oops, another potential head on. Another snap roll to avoid. Okay, I've got a good shot on this P40. Let's make it count. Okay, I've lost track of where the 109 is. I just have to hope my friends are onto him. This P40 has got to go. Okay, good. Now, where is he? Oh, okay, we're all together. Where is the 190? He's dived away. There he is down there at the ground level. Job well done. Team Buffalo has secured high altitude against higher tiered competition. Okay, so what's next? For targets to boom and zoom, of course. I've got a few planes just spawning in. Nice mess of them down there, so let's give them a run and see what happens. They've all turned away from me to run toward the base, so first of all, this Yak-9, here we go. Aim well ahead and walk the shots back. Okay. Yep, Corsair. Two. Right, Spitfire. I'll take that. That was nice. Okay, just extending it away because I've got no idea where everyone else is. It looks like I'm clear. So I'll just regain some altitude and then look to come back and join my squad mates back up there. Here's where the lack of zoom climbing ability on the Buffalo might be a bit of a problem. Might be easier said than done to get back up to altitude and rejoin those guys. At this point I've jumped to a stage later on in the battle and I've got a Hellcat on my tail and I'm running with a fast dying engine. Now I wanted to get closer to friendlies, especially my teammates who are respawning. And then I was going to look to turn fight him if I still had an engine left. And then hopefully even make it over to A so I could land and try for a repair. Anyway, I'm about to break and start dogfighting, which shakes him off my tail quite nicely, and other people kill him, but my engine is dead. And unfortunately I can't make it to A, so I have to coast and, sadly, land the plane. And while I do so, let me review the tactics for flying the Buffalo. First and foremost, it is an energy fighter. You can boom and zoom with it really well. You can obviously intercept with it. You can hunt bombers with it. Just do whatever you do. Don't get in a situation where you're coming under enemy gunfire unless you can help it. It can turn fight very well for an energy fighter. However, it is not the best turn fighter in the sky, so you should save that for situations when you're absolutely forced to use your maneuverability, or when you're under no threat and you can dispense with an enemy in isolation. When I first started collecting footage for this video, I'd already flown it 68 times, I'd only killed 64 planes with it, with 39 deaths. That's a very, very ordinary record, but then I'd flown it quite a bit when I was quite a new pilot. I'd also flown it quite a lot as a backup plane for when I'd lost other planes. And over the last couple of days, I've flown it another 8 times, I've died twice, and killed another 38 targets, which is much more representative of the abilities of this plane. Even at a battle rating of 2.7, this plane is certainly competitive. It probably belongs at 2.3, but that doesn't mean it can't be flown where it currently is. And we had a lot of fun flying the plane in the games that I've recorded here. So, well, I hope you found the video enjoyable, and I encourage you to fly this plane whenever you feel like a change of pace, as it really is a lot of fun. And that's what the game's all about. Until the next video, I'll see you in the skies.